Call of Duty. Why is it so popular? Is it because of the trick shotters? Or is it the people who play the game for fun and just to mess around?
We lost that round, but it's not over yet. Step up.
Or maybe is it because of the competitive community? I think the answer is all of the above. Call of Duty is so popular because there are so many ways to play it, so you can play your way. Feel like using a light machine gun like I am in this video? Go right ahead. Feel like using a sniper and hiding in some houses? Feel free. Or, you know, you could just run around with only a knife. You can do that too. You can do anything in this game, and that's why so many people like it. Now, if you're a Call of Duty hater, I don't know what to say to you. I mean, some people don't like the game. I personally don't see why, but you're entitled to your own opinion, I guess? Time for some Call of Duty history. Call of Duty is owned by Activision and made by Infinity Ward and Treyarch Games, and now also Sledgehammer, who is making the newest Call of Duty to be released in 2014. The first Call of Duty was released for PC in 2003, which is now better known as Call of Duty 1, since there are so many. Like many of the earlier Call of Duties, this Call of Duty was based around World War II. Now the next Call of Duty, Call of Duty Finest Hour, is interesting. It was released in 2004, and it is interesting because it was supposed to be based off the Call of Duty 1 for PC, but they ended up making great changes to it and it became its own game for the consoles. Next we have Call of Duty 2, released in 2005, which, depending on how you look at it, could be considered as the third Call of Duty. Much like Call of Duty 1, this game is based around World War II. Now with Call of Duty 2 comes the introduction of multiplayer, and this is big. Next up is Call of Duty 3, released in 2006. It had both improved multiplayer and improved campaign. Call of Duty 4, Modern Warfare, was released in 2007, and this is where things really took off. Commonly thought of as one of the best Call of Duties of all time, the multiplayer on Call of Duty 4 was spectacular. Call of Duty 4 is when Call of Duty really got big and popular. Even though the game is now 7 years old, people still play its multiplayer like crazy. After Call of Duty Modern Warfare comes Call of Duty World at War, released in 2008. After that comes Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2, released in 2009, which is also still a commonly played game. After that is Call of Duty Black Ops in 2010, and then Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 in 2011. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 is when I actually started playing Call of Duty. After Modern Warfare 3 comes Call of Duty Black Ops 2, released in 2012, Call of Duty Ghosts, released in 2013, and the soon upcoming Call of Duty Advanced Warfare to be released in November of 2014. Now these of course are not all of the Call of Duty games, but just the main ones. If I were to cover all of the Call of Duties, it would take me a clean 20 minutes to list them all off, because that's how many games Call of Duty has made. Now what is Call of Duty multiplayer? Well, Call of Duty multiplayer is what you're watching right now. To be more specific, you're watching Search and Destroy on Call of Duty multiplayer. There are many game modes on Call of Duty multiplayer, anywhere from Team Deathmatch to Infected to Gun Game to Search and Destroy to Capture the Flag to Domination. There are too many to list off. Now in multiplayer, you either get put on a team if you're playing in team-based game modes, or you play against everybody else solo in free-for-all type game modes. Now, multiplayer, all you do is you either, like I just said, play by yourself or play on a team to complete whatever the game type you're playing is objective. Like, for example, you're watching me play Search and Destroy right now, which is a team-based game. I'm on a team, and I'm either trying to destroy one of the two bomb sites or defend both of them from being destroyed, depending on which team I am and what round it is. There are many, many game modes, like the ones I've previously listed, like Team Deathmatch, where the score is set to 75, and all it is two teams, and whichever team reaches 75 kills first wins. Now, I've given you the basics of Call of Duty multiplayer. What else makes it fun? Well, there are a lot of additional things in multiplayer that make multiplayer fun, such as prestiging, camos, etc., etc. Prestiging is when, in every Call of Duty, there's a max level, and you gain XP for winning games and killing people and doing really good. You get XP and you level up, just like almost every other game with a leveling system. Once you hit max level, that's not actually max level, because you can do a thing called prestiging, which resets your level back to level 1, but gives you a cool new emblem besides your level. Now, your level is displayed in the pregame lobby, which is where you wait for a game to begin after you find people to play the game with. And when you get a new prestige icon, it just gives you a feeling of accomplishment. Plus, they look really cool. Now, weapon camos are when you do really good with a certain gun, or just use a certain gun a lot in complete challenges, and you get new camos to put on your gun. If you do good enough, the best camo is gold, except in Black Ops 2 where they put in a diamond camo. Now, these are obviously really rewarding because it takes a long time to get them and is often very difficult to get weapon camos. So when you're walking around with a gold gun, not only does it look awesome, it's actually impressive because it's difficult to get, and that is very rewarding. Now, here are some fun facts just to show you how big Call of Duty is. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 is the fastest selling Call of Duty game of all time at 8.8 million copies sold in its first month. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 made more money during its launch than Hollywood. Modern Warfare 3 made $775 million in its first 5 days of release. This is more than any movie has ever made in that amount of time. If you added up all gamers' time on Call of Duty, it would add up to almost 2,000 years of gameplay a day. The cost of all UAVs destroyed in Call of Duty could cover the US's budget. Call of Duty has been played for 25 billion hours. 18 billion multiplayer matches have been played on Call of Duty. Call of Duty's daily players could fill 80 of the world's largest sports stadiums. Players of Call of Duty multiplayer have respawned 1.9 quadrillion times. 31 billion care packages have been dropped in Call of Duty multiplayer. And last but not least, 100 million people have played Call of Duty. Now, if that doesn't give you an idea as to how big Call of Duty is, I don't know what will, because there are lots of other things I didn't even talk about, lots of other things I didn't even touch on, but Call of Duty is definitely one of the world's, if not the world's, best-selling video game series, and it is enjoyed by so many people, it's not even funny. I hope you have enjoyed this informational documentary, and if you already knew these things, I'm sorry for wasting your time, but I hope you enjoyed the gameplay. But, yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys next time.